input, government is all ready to answer all the questions, especially on the NEET controversy. And if required, Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan may intervene during the discussion of the motion of thanks to the President address. So these are the latest inputs that we have. Inputs that we are tracking at this point of time. The drama over the NEET in India continues as the National Testing Agency comes under a lot of scrutiny, bringing in the central government also under a lot of discussion. Now, Payal continues to stay with us on the broadcast. Payal, what specific concerns regarding NEET are expected to be raised during the entire discussion?
Well, the entire formation of NEET is functioning. The fact that there were so many exams cancelled, that is something which opposition parties have been asking. The common man has also been asking several questions as well. You've seen multiple briefings taking place, you know, under the Ministry of Education. Officers have come out, the minister has come out and clarified as well, but it doesn't seem to have cut much ice, especially with the opposition parties. And that's the reason today morning at 10:45 a.m. when Rahul Gandhi speaks at Vijay Chowk, it'll be important to see what he really says, because that's going to set the mood for the remaining part of the parliament session. But, you know, if the clarification is required and the opposition continues to press on the issue, then the government is saying that they're not running away from any answers, because that the government says they are a responsible government who's answerable to the cause of the people, answerable to the people of the country as well. So you could expect Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan to make an intervention. So during the debate, you know, union ministers can make an intervention on important issues. And Dharmendra Pradhan has been asked to make an intervention as and when the opposition parties speak about the entire issue.
Right, Payal. Help us also understand, how does the government plan to address the scrutiny of the NTA, especially when we are also learning of the fact that Dharmendra Pradhan, the education minister, is also likely to intervene in the detailed discussions on this entire controversy?
Well, absolutely. Dharmendra Pradhan has also been saying that he laid bare all the facts. The fact that he came out and said that I take sole responsibility because I am the abhivahak, I'm basically representative of the people of the country, especially the students as well. I can't run away from my responsibility. So the functioning of the NTA, the functioning of the body, that committee, which has been the high-profile committee, as the government said, has been already formed. The government is very confident that this committee will in fact give its reports within the next 2 months, which also speaks over the various reforms that can really happen. But you know, any other functioning of what really happened, and you know, many people have questioned the government as to why NTA was really formed. But what was who in principle gave the approval for NTA in the UPA days? That is also something which Dharmendra Pradhan is going to highlight. This was probably part of the early education policy also, which is, you know, important to see this side of a body of like NTA to be formed and exams to be conducted the way it's been conducted over the last 4 to 5 years. So all the questions will be answered. It's going to be a political written speech. So far, Dharmendra Pradhan has refrained from making any political comments, even though we asked him, of multiple leaders wanting to question the intent of the government, multiple leaders asking him to step down as a education minister. But he so far has refrained from saying anything political, because he feels that he does not want to create a panic among the students. He does not want to make it a political issue. But on the floor of the house, if political jibe is thrown at the government, Dharmendra Pradhan, he's an experienced politician, he's also been a sitting minister in the Modi government, in the 2.0 government, he's going to come out with facts, and he's also going to come out with a very politically laden speech.
Right, Payal. Thank you so much for bringing in all those details. The drama over the NEET in India continues to escalate as the National Testing Agency comes under a lot of scrutiny. Allegations of irregularities and discrepancies have sparked widespread concern and debates, not amongst only the students and educators, but also in Parliament. We'll continue to track all those details, but right now we're slipping into a very short break. Stay tuned. We'll be back.